Welcome to Tell Nigerians. We are right now at the Nigerian Embassy in Bern, Switzerland, and I'm with Honorable Kenneth Gbandi, the President of Nigerians in Diaspora Organization Europe. We are happy to have you in Switzerland, sir. How are you doing?
Thank you so much.
How was your journey to Switzerland?
Very, very fantastic. You know, this is a second home.
Yes. It's the boss, Nigerians in Diaspora Organization Europe. How do you feel? What, from the old stuff you've heard today, what will be your how do you want to present this to your group, to the Nigerians in Europe?
Well, like I said during my remark with His Excellency, we agree there's an issue in NIDO, Switzerland, and after extensive deliberation with the board of directors, the board of trustees, which comprises the chapter chairs and the central executive council, I was directed to carry out a fact-finding mission.
Okay.
To Switzerland to listen to all the stakeholders and then report back to them. I came, like you rightly pointed out, I've listened, and I'm going to go back to report to them. But I can tell you what I've had today is purely amazing, pretty amazing, and very, very challenging and informative. And I am very, very much humbled that His Excellency took time off, you know, and to address NIDO Europe, and to actually, catalog what happened before the two election, and eventually what happened after election. And I think the position of the embassy is very, very clear. And then we are going to take that challenge, do our final report, and make a recommendation to the embassy and also for the board of trustees. That's what we're going to do.
Okay, thank you very much, sir. And as you know, according to what we've gathered today, there was a second election. And according to what you said, NIDO Europe tried reaching them and they couldn't get back. That means you don't recognize them anyway. But generally, what would you have to tell people like this, a group like this?
Well, the issue of election and the running an organization should not be a do or die affair among Nigerians in Europe. It's very unfortunate, like I said in my remark, that we want to tell, you know, the Nigerian politicians or the politic in Nigeria want to tell them how best to do things, and but we can't get our arts here in the diaspora. But of course, it's painful because the very few arts of the art of few is being termed to be a general art. We have some very, very brilliant Nigerians in the diaspora. People like you, we have seen so many doctors and lawyers here today. You've seen IT experts today. So we are more than just the very few, you know, few individuals who are, you know, bringing Nigerians' bad name in the diaspora. So I want to focus on those groups. To ask those groups, do not be deterred. They're going to attack you, the bullets are going to come, but keep your head high and do exactly what you have to do. The plan of this executive, if I might use that word, which I've listened to, is totally elaborate, very, very, you know, ambitious, and I think if well implemented, they're going to win the hearts of so many Nigerians here in Switzerland.
Okay, thank you very much, sir. We saw that from the presentation the president made, Mr. Johnson Odibo. We saw that he had like an average of 6,000 Nigerians in Switzerland. And from the information we gathered today, we know that we're about 22 members of NIDO Swiss. How do you see this?
I want to be very, very frank to say that I don't think that's a problem.
Okay.
And the Nigerian National Organization is a professional organization.
Okay.
While we welcome all Nigerians as an interface organization, we represent the interests of all Nigerians, but NIDO is a professional organization.
Okay.
And when I say professional, don't get me wrong. You don't need to be a bank manager. You don't need to be, you know, an oil expert to be a professional. Even a taxi driver can be a professional if he is well trained to contribute to, you know, to improving his trade. And if he has something he can also bring to Nigeria in his profession, so he's a professional.
Okay.
So I think those who can add value to Nigeria and who can add value to fellow Nigerians here are termed, in our view, as professionals. But not to make that mistake, what we need to do as NIDO, and what we have actually started doing as NIDO Europe, is to have a synergy with all Nigerian organizations. And what we have started to do in NIDO Europe is to establish what we call a Nigerian Organizations Strategic Assembly.
Okay.
Where you have the leaders of these different ethnic groups or different professional groups that meet regularly with NIDO to exchange ideas on issues of national interest, and also exchange ideas what is going on within the organization and how can we be able to, you know, benefit from from each other. To have the notion that every single individual in Switzerland, in Germany, in UK, should be a member of NIDO is absurd, because okay. it's not going to be very possible. We don't have every Nigerian as APC members, and we don't have every Nigerian as a PDP members.
True.
So we have members of a group that represent the interest of the majority. What we need to do is to work out a modality on how to reach out and interact with everybody.
Thank you very much, sir. And we are still hoping to get more information about the national identity, this idea that we have before, and now we're trying to bring it to Switzerland. How soon do you think we can have it in Switzerland?
Well, with what I am seeing on the ground, you can be sure that I'm going to impress on Biosec,
okay.
Who is our NIDO strategic partner, that the time is ripe for a flag up in Switzerland.
Okay.
We are currently operating in five regions in Europe, and they were looking at kicking off in Sweden, in UK, and also now in Switzerland. So I think the time is ripe. And with a very cordial working relationship with Nigerian embassy in Switzerland, I mean from the central executive perspective, I think the issue of flagging up shouldn't be any problem any longer with the active support of Nigerian embassy.
Thank you very much. Based on what you've said, what do you want to tell Nigerians in Switzerland?
Well, I have to tell them that time to bring in their expertise, their know-how, the time is now, because we have executive at the central that recognizes the talent of Nigerians and the added value that they can bring to Nigerian organization. I want to mention briefly that we are working on the diaspora housing project that is going to, you know, looking at 650,000 housing in the next 10 years with our partners. We have successfully flagged up Nigerian diaspora registration. We're looking at the diaspora voting. We're having a conference coming up in July in Nigeria, where we're going to be examining so many issues that relate to the diaspora. And of course, diaspora voting, diaspora housing, diaspora registration, and of course, the issue of good governance will be on the major agenda. Of course, security of life of every Nigerian is also going to be on the agenda. And so these are the things that we think is a new happening in NIDO, and I want every Nigerian in Switzerland to be part of that by joining NIDO Swiss, which means, when I mean join every Nigerian that is qualified, that has something to offer to NIDO, to please take the opportunity to be on board. And also, I would advise the NIDO Switzerland chapter to reach out to us, to Nigerian. And I think from what I saw today in the presentation, there's an elaborate plan from Mr. Chairman, how he wants to reach out to so many Nigerian organizations. I mean, I will say that without any fear of contradiction, we are invited. He has invited us to Switzerland to listen to them, and we gladly took the invitation. And today we learn more, and we're wiser today than we were 3, 4, 5 weeks.
Thank you very much, sir. The Chairman, NIDO Europe, Honorable Kenneth Gbandi, has just said everything that Nigerians would like to hear in Switzerland. And I want to thank you very much for taking your time to come to Switzerland. And we wish you a very nice journey back to Deutschland.
Thank you.
You are in Hamburg.
It's always nice having you on your program.
Thank you very much.
So keep telling Africans and keep telling Nigerians.
Thank you very much.
And please keep doing a good job.
Thank you very much, sir.
You're welcome.
Happy to see you. Bye bye.
Tell Nigerians in Switzerland too. Tell Nigerians in Europe. Tell Nigerians everywhere in the world that there is a new wind blowing. They should key into this new wind, and their potentials will be harnessed.
The core mandate as Nigerian in diaspora is to mobilize the resources of Nigerians, especially intellectual resources. But of course, what I mean intellectual, I'm not talking only about university degrees. I'm talking about the experiences which Nigerians have gathered across the globe. And so we want to gather and mobilize these resources together and form a kind of a pool in the pursuit of national development.